Hey everyone, welcome to another video. In this video I'm testing out the new Glamlight Happy Hour collection. I get two of the palettes. I got the chocolate martini palette, the neutral palette, and also the dirty martini palette, the green palette in the series. And I'm gonna do a look with both of them, show some swatches, share my first impressions. So let's get right into it. So if you haven't been on my channel before, my name is Marley and I love making YouTube videos about makeup and beauty. I love trying out new makeup. I love focusing on indie brands as well. So if that sounds good to you, then don't forget to subscribe. I usually upload about 2 to 3 videos a week and I would love to see you again on my channel. So Glamlight recently released a new collection with 4 different eyeshadow palettes based on drinks, alcoholic drinks. And I got 2 of the palettes. There are 2 more. There's also purple one and one that's more colorful. I got the 2 that I thought were most interesting, that I was most excited about. There's also some highlighters and I believe there's also a lip set. So if you're interested in this collection, there's more than what I'm showing you in this video. So first up here, I have the chocolate martini palette. It comes in a bottle like this. When you first get it, it comes in a bottle like this. This is the outer packaging and it's meant to look like an alcohol bottle. And then you open it up and then this is what the palette looks like. Luckily, it's not as big and bulky as the plastic bottle packaging. And this is what the inside of the palette looks like. It's a neutral palette, but we definitely have a bunch of different shades here. You can go a little bit more purple. We even have a bluish purple shimmer. We have some golds, we have some warm tones, we have some mauve tones, and there's even a shimmer that's a little bit like a burnt orange with a golden shift. So it definitely isn't a palette that is a very, very neutral leaning, as in the undertone isn't very neutral. We have some shades with interesting undertones here. So if you're looking for a neutral palette, then this might not be for you. But if you're looking for a neutral palette that has a little bit of interest to it, it's a little bit different, then this is a very nice color story. So I will also put up some swatches where you can really see what these shades look like from up close. The shimmers in here are very beautiful, very gorgeous. I really, really like how these look. And we can build some depth with this palette. We have a deep brown here, a deep brown matte, and we also have a deep brown shimmer. So I actually did the look with this palette yesterday. I just filmed me applying it. I didn't film me talking about it, telling you what I did, but I will tell you right now and just show you the look that I did. So what I did was I first put the shade Irish Cream in my crease, kind of blended it out, used it as a transition shade. Then I went into the shade called Syrup and put that in my crease as well. Blended it out with a crease brush, just kind of used that as a transition shade. Then I used the shade Creme de Cacao, so I deepened it up a little bit more. These shades have a bit of a warm reddish undertone, so you get a little bit of more of a warm and reddish crease. I used the shade Chocolate Liqueur, and that is a dark brown shimmer with some golden flecks in there as well. Kind of used that in the outer part, on the outer part of the eyelid, to kind of create some extra depth there. I also took the shade Dark Chocolate, the dark brown, and deepened up the outer corner to really build that depth, but also add a little bit of coolness to the look as well. I put the shade Living Lavish, so that kind of burnt orange bronzy shade that's kind of bright. I put that on the lid to add a bunch of warmth to the look. For the lower lash line, I use a combination of bittersweet and dark chocolate, kind of smoked that out, deepened that up. And I also put the shade Ganache on the lower lash line and kind of added a bit of shimmer there. I tried to use the shade Vanilla Vodka as an inner corner highlight, but that didn't really work out. It turns out to be a very, very deep, actually it looks white in the pan, but the shift is so strong that it's quite a deep gold. So I decided to add something else over top later to kind of add that lightness in the inner corner. But it's a really pretty shade, it just didn't really work like that. So I really loved the look that I did with it. It became a little bit of a mix of warm tones and cool tones. I could create quite a bit of depth and it looked very nice and smoky, kind of bronzy almost. I was really happy with the look of the shimmers. The mattes blended really well. They blended out very easily. I thought it was a very, very pretty look. Then the Dirty Martini palette. This is a green palette that has a bunch of different options. You can go quite bright green, but you can also go a little bit more teal. We can go a little bit more olive here. We have a few shimmers that are a little bit on the neutral side. So you have a lot of options. There is a lot you can do in terms of green, but you can also keep it a little bit softer. I think there are a lot of very nice tones in here. I really love the color choices. That's also why I bought this palette, why I thought I could use this palette, because I don't really love a really bright olive or a really bright warm green, but I saw that there were a lot of options here and I saw a lot of looks that I would want to do, even though I'm not the biggest fan of warm greens. So here once again we have a lot of beautiful shimmers, a lot of beautiful colors. The mattes swatched very well. The shimmers look very, very shiny. I think this is a beautiful color story, a beautiful looking palette. So let's get into the look with the Dirty Martini palette. Alright, so let's get into the second look. The second look is of course gonna be with the Dirty Martini palette. And we have so many nice green options here. I see a lot of things that I would like to do. We have some pretty more olivey tones over here, but I'm also very drawn towards these kind of bluey greens, teal shades. But I feel like I've done a lot of kind of olivey looks lately, so I'm thinking, so I kind of want to go into these more bluey greens over here and test those out. So I think I'm just gonna put these two shades, these two mattes in the crease, and then do something with those bluey shimmers as well. Maybe I can do something on the lower lash line that's a little bit more on the green side. So I'm just gonna take a crease brush, let me see, and I'm just gonna take the shade Classic, so the lighter of the greeny blues, and I'm gonna put that in my crease. I'm already wearing eye primer and I'm just gonna blend this in. I'm really hoping that these teals are gonna be good because I love teal eyeshadow. It's one of my favorite eyeshadow colors to wear. And this one's very pigmented. It goes on very easily. That is looking very good. Didn't take a lot of effort to blend out. Just gonna do this on the other eye. So that is a very pretty looking shade. It's pretty bright. It looks a little bit, it actually looks a little bit brighter than I was expecting. It looks a little bit less gray in undertone on my eyes than it does in the pan, but I really, really like it. So for the next step, I'm gonna go and grab the shade, mix it up, and I'm gonna deepen up the outer corner. Just taking a crease brush that's a little bit more precise, and I'm gonna start deepening this up. I'm gonna be patting it down first and then slowly blending it out. Just gonna add a little bit more. This is a little bit of a powdery shade, but it is very pigmented and it does blend out quite easily. I feel like you just have to be a little bit careful not to get too much on your brush. And I'm just doing the same on the other side. So far, this is looking good. Okay, for the next step, I'm gonna go into some shimmers. And I'm first gonna put the shimmer called Gin on the middle of the lid. And I'm gonna put on the rocks this bluey shimmer towards the inner part. And I'm just gonna be doing that with my finger. I always like applying my shimmers with my fingers. It's just my personal preference. That one is really, really pretty. Really pigmented, very shiny. It has a nice amount of texture. I really, really like the Glam Light shimmers. These are like some of my fave shimmers that I have tried. So now going into the shade called On the Rocks, and I'm just putting that towards the inner part. That's very nice and shiny, a little bit more silvery in undertone. Okay, I really like this. This is a very, very pretty. And now I'm just gonna take the deepest blue called Mix It Up again. And I'm just gonna deepen up the outer corner a little bit with this. I lost a little bit of this color here. I just put the shimmer over top. Next up, for the lower lash line, I first want to go into this shade over here, this olive tone. I actually don't know how I should pronounce this. I always say this word and I just don't know. Is it like vermouth? Like dry vermouth? I don't know. Or vermouth? Vermouth? Well, at least it's the dark olive-y shade. And I'm just gonna take a flat brush and apply it to the lower lash line. This is definitely more of a warm toned olive. Some olives that I've tried pull pretty cool, but this has a definite warm undertone. Just adding a bit of smokiness over here. This is a very pigmented shade. I think you can create quite a bit of depth with this one. And now I think I just want to take a little bit of the shade called Extra Dirty and put it towards the outer part of the lower lash line to kind of add a little bit more depth there. And then I might blend it out into the crease a little bit. This is a bit of a brown green, but with a very, very slight green undertone. Just taking the crease brush and kind of blending this together. Just gonna take a little bit of that Extra Dirty shade and applying that out here. Just deepening up a little bit and making sure that everything blends together. I feel like this is working quite well with the teals. Now for the lower lash line, I'm just gonna take the shade called Crisp and I'm gonna put that towards the inner part to kind of add a little bit of shimmer there. I'm just gonna take a pencil brush and applying that over here. This shimmer is a little bit more cool tone, so it kind of ties everything together a little bit more. Alright, so I like how this is looking. There's not really an inner corner highlight in this palette. All the shimmers are pretty deep, so I'm just gonna take something else for the inner corner highlight, but this is gonna be the eye look so far with the Dirty Martini palette. I'm just gonna finish everything up, do the rest of my makeup, and then I'll be back with my thoughts. So this is the finished look. I really, really love how this turned out. I think the greens worked so well, are so pigmented. I really love the shine of the shimmers. This is a very, very beautiful green look. The darkest green that I use, you have to be a little bit careful with because it's a little bit powdery and very pigmented. So if you're not careful, you can kind of smear it around. I kind of had to be careful when I put concealer under my eyes and cleaned up under my eyes. So that's the only thing I kind of felt like I had to be mindful of. So let's quickly chat about these palettes. I think that these two palettes are really, really beautiful, really, really nice. I quite like the way they did the packaging. It's a bit simple, but at least it's sleek and it's easy to store. I'm not losing my mind over it, but it's pretty cute. The bottles weren't exactly necessary if you ask me, but they are cute. They add a little bit of interest, and of course Glamlight always loves to do something a little bit extra, so I get why they do it, but I'm gonna probably throw those out after this video. I really loved working with both. We have quite a range of shades here. We have some depth here. We have a lot of options. I did notice that in both these palettes there isn't any shade for the inner corner, so you just have to grab something else for that. But I thought both these color stories are really beautiful. I can go many different routes with them. I'm really happy that I got these palettes. I would definitely recommend them, at least so far. I of course haven't tried all the shades. I always come back to the things that I do first impressions on in a roundup video where I rank all my new purchases. So I'm gonna be testing them out a little bit more, and then if you want to know my final thoughts, then definitely keep an eye out for that video. But so far I'm really impressed and really happy with these palettes. So that's gonna be everything for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like this video if you liked it, and don't forget to subscribe, and then I will see you in my next one. Bye bye.